I just want to share what I've learned about line pointing. It seems to me a lot of people don't want to write stuff down, or they don't want to share information because, you know, they want to keep it a mysterious art, you know, this mystery line. So I just want to share what I've learned. There are four things. First thing is keep the sun off it, keep the rain off it, keep the wind off it, and keep it damp. So irrespective of whether you're indoors or outdoors, we're indoors here, you keep it damp using something like this, and you just spray it. And you can do that twice a day. Just spray it down, keep it damp. And you've got to do this for 10 days. Also have some wet hessian. If you don't have hessian, you can use the decorators dust sheets that are made of cotton. They're a bit harder to soak, but you can use those. And you hang that over the wall as well. And when you go to spray it down, you just take it off, spray it down, then put it back on. Or you can just go underneath it, underneath the hessian, and just spray it. To keep the sun and the wind off it, use a tarpaulin. If you're indoors, you've still got to keep the sun off it, because the windows, sun comes through the window, goes onto the wall, it dries it out quicker in that spot. So even if you're indoors, keep the sun off it. Obviously the rain and the wind aren't a problem indoors. When you're outdoors and you put the tarpaulin on, to keep the wind off it, you really got to clamp the tarpaulin to the wall at the edges. So you don't just hang the tarpaulin loosely against the wall. You actually got to use like a wooden batten at the top and the sides to clamp it down, because otherwise the wind will just get underneath it and it just dries it out. And then what happens when it dries out too quickly is it will turn bright white and go powdery. I'll show you some really bad pointing I did at the beginning, just as an experiment, just to show you what it's like when it's too dry. So this is internally, and you can see it's not too bad. I don't know if you can see that. It's not too bad. But basically, keep the sun off, keep the rain off, keep the wind off, and keep it damp for 10 days. Now, when you put it in, I put the putty on a plasterer's trowel. I would have used an SDS drill to chisel out the old pointing. In this case, it was cement. You got your lime putty on your plasterer's trowel. You put it up to the bricks like that. And then you push it in using one of these. So you push it in. You've got to get a bit of a bend into this, because lime is a packing material. It's got no adhesive stickiness. Cement will stick to stuff, whereas this stuff, it doesn't stick. So you've got to compress it. As it's drying out, after about, say, 2 to 6 hours, when it's dry and it still feels a little bit squidgy, it would have shrunk a little bit. So you get a churn brush and you whack the churn brush against the wall, not gently, but hard, because you've really got to compress this stuff. So when you're putting it in, you know, don't be afraid to put a bit of a bend into this and squash it in. And then after a couple of hours, churn brush it. Important, when you churn brush it, the face of the brick must be dry, otherwise you'll stain it. I'll show you in a second what that looks like as well. So the other type of lime is the stuff that reacts with water. So you get a bag, it's dry, you mix water, and it reacts with the water to set. It sets a bit quicker, it's more hard and rigid, but it's less breathable. This stuff is the stuff that reacts with the CO2 in the air. So it takes longer to dry, but it's more breathable, which is why I'm using it. It's just a difficult process to learn how to do it, because nothing's ever written down and there's lots of bad advice on the internet. But remember, compress it in. After a couple of hours, churn brush it to recompress it, because it would have shrunk a little bit. Keep it damp for 10 days, keep the sun off it, keep the rain off it, keep the wind off it. And I'll just show you what happens when you stain the bricks and you let it dry out too quick. I'll just quickly show you. So this wall here, you can see, there's a bad example. When I did the churn brush, the brick face was damp. So of course, you end up with a bit of lime when you're churn brushing. And it sticks to the face of the brick and it stains it. So that's one thing you don't want to do. If you just put lime on and you just leave it. You don't cover it up, you don't dampen it, and you just leave it in the sun. It will just dry out too quickly, and I'll just show you what that looks like. So just as an experiment, I just put some lime on and I just left it, and you see it's absolutely bright white. It should be a beige colour, and look how powdery it is. You know, I just scrape away at it. There's no strength to it. It's just falling off. And that's because it goes white because as it dries out, the lime is drawn to the surface. And it just doesn't have to, it dries out too quickly before it's had a chance to react with the CO2 in the air. So you can see it's got just no strength. So that's what happens. It's bright white, and you just take a stone and it'll just flake away. No strength to it. The other thing is, if you're laying a brick wall and you got, say, 10 centimetres of depth of lime, it's a little bit more forgiving because there's a greater reserve of water behind it. But when you're pointing, it's only 10 to 20 mil deep. And so as it dries out, there's no further wet mortar behind it to continue to supply water. So when it's really shallow depth, 10 to 20 mil, it's less forgiving. If this was like all the way through 10 centimetres deep, there's a greater reserve of water, so it's a little bit more forgiving. But yeah, when you do your tarpaulin, you don't want it just hanging on like this. You actually want a bit of wood, and you actually want to clamp it tight to the wall to stop the wind getting up underneath it, otherwise it'll just blow. And the same down the sides, you know, not loose like this. Bit of wood up against the wall, clamping it to it to stop the wind getting underneath it. That's what I've learned so far. I hope that helps anyone who's trying to teach themselves how to do this. All the best.